a different skate park this morning, one a bit further down the road. I'll give you a look around.
Hi guys, just wanted to quickly pause the video and explain you may see some choppiness and stuttering. I'm filming on a Samsung S7. It's a couple of years old now. Probably about 2 years, maybe a bit older. But I don't think the issue is age related. I wanted to film at 1080p, 60 frames per second. It looked quite good quality, so I thought I'd try it out with some skate footage. I tried to edit out as much as I could, but some of the leaving some in was unavoidable. It's also quite a windy location, so you may hear the microphone getting buffeted a bit. On with the video.
The reason why I've come here today is to try and get a 50-50 stall on the coping of a quarter pipe or a mini ramp, this quarter pipe here. I've been trying to learn it on a much harder quarter pipe for quite a while, and it's just too difficult. So I've come to this skate park because it's smaller here and I should stand a better chance of eventually landing one. Wish me luck. Let's do some skateboarding. Closest I've ever been. I've never been that close before. I haven't been here for a long time, so my boarding must have improved a bit. So at least I'm getting onto the coping.
I just wanted to explain that it was at this moment I realised I was going to have to do a drop in from the 50-50 axle stall position on top of the coping. That young lad is asking me what board size do I ride. He's also telling me that he can rock to fakie and almost land a kickflip despite never really riding skateboards and never really has ridden skateboards. Later near the end of my session, he tried. He didn't come close to landing either. I thought I would leave this unedited just to show you how long it took me to find the courage to actually attempt the drop-in. I found it really scary to commit, because if those back trucks hang up, you could potentially face plant right into the concrete, and it's, even though you're 3 foot high, it seems a long way down straight to the concrete. And that's probably because my eyes are probably another 6.5 feet up in the air while standing on the skateboard. So from that, my whole upper body will have to fall that far down to the concrete. The young lads are watching now, so I'm probably starting to feel the pressure. It probably helped speed up the process. I imagine my ego was overly concerned about appearing weak, which in moments like this I don't seem to have any control over. Right, I'm about to go. Go on, you can do it. And there I go. But I fell, but that's okay. I didn't mind that. At least I attempted it. Now I know kind of what's in store for me. Once I realised the trick was in two moves, the ride up the transition onto the coping and then the actual drop in from the coping, I felt that I should get to grips with the drop in first, just so that I'm ready for when I actually do land on top of the coping. What I managed to figure out after some trial and error was it all depends upon that left back wheel if you ride goofy and the right back wheel if you ride regular. You need to use that left back wheel as a pivot point and rotate the front of the skateboard around onto the transition. If you do that by focusing on that left back wheel, you should be okay and the rear trucks shouldn't go back over the coping and cause you to hang up.
Absolutely terrifying. Dropping in from the coping from that 50-50 stall position is absolutely terrifying. You have no idea how much fear I have to overcome to be able to just do it. Because the scooter kids are around, I thought I had to be a bit braver. So it's because of them, they gave me actual courage. I was being a big baby. Exactly what to do now. I probably won't do it all the time, but I definitely know how to do it now. I know how to swing it around and land with my front wheels on the transition. I can feel what I'm supposed to do. I feel like I've got it locked in 95% of the time. So that's progress.
Now starting to realize what you have to do to stall your skateboard on top of the coping. You have to slightly lighten the load on the skateboard so it can rise up over the coping. And the way I did that was to shift my weight, like doing a jump without actually jumping. Oh yeah, and also you have to commit to turning the shoulders so they end up parallel with the coping. And as you can see, I started getting more consistent and landing them more frequently. And that was the one I was happy with. It all ended a bit abruptly, so I added the slow motion clipping just to drag the end of the video out a bit. I stopped filming after this and went home.
Well, I finally did it, 50-50 axle stall. It's such a good feeling to finally get it. I've been trying for a long time. Yeah, I'm so pleased I finally did it. See you in the next video, and thank you for watching.